close the roll, and tally the votes.
13 ayes.
Yes, and we'll move this forthwith without objection. And it is passed. Okay.
So today, to all of the future federal leaders that are going to take over very soon, I tell them this, that with this action today, what the LA City Council is trying to say is that we're not going to allow for the actions that once upon a time took place in 1954 with Operation, I don't choose to use a second word, or what happened in the 1970s when they did massive deportations and broke families. Los Angeles is not going to let that happen.
Thank you. Councilmember Price, followed by Councilwoman Padilla.
Thank you, Mr. President. Given the re-election of Donald Trump and the consistent hate speech towards undocumented people and mixed-status families, I can't think of a more pressing issue than this one today. Sanctuary cities are not just a legal framework, but they represent a moral commitment to upholding human dignity, protecting families, and ensuring that everyone, regardless of their immigrating status, can live without fear.
Actually ended up at the U.S. Supreme Court. We went on.
And we don't have a safer city if people are living in fear and hiding in the shadows and unable to come forward and cooperate with law enforcement in manners that we need them to, particularly because we want to keep them safe. We want to ensure that they are cooperative and communicating with law enforcement officials to make sure that if they are either the victims or the witness of a crime, their testimony is going to be instrumental to making sure that this city is safer for everyone.
No city resources, property, or personnel should be used for immigration enforcement.
If we know anything about the person who just won the election, we know that their bark is their bark, and their bark matches their bite.
Councilmember Rahman, Councilmember Hernandez, and others who helped shape this.
And we know that women should be able to report domestic violence and seek justice. Kids should be able to go to school, and families should be able to go to public libraries without the fear that doing so would tear their families apart. So by passing this law today, we are making sure that we are keeping our friends, family, neighbors, and coworkers safe.
And Mr. Herman, you are standing up during